Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. Now, in a previous video, we showed you our version of the rubber band rocket cup. It works like this. Stretch a rubber band across a cup, have another cup as a launch pad, press it down, hold, and release. Now, a big part of science is changing something to see if we can make it work better. So, we're going to try to change this to see if we can get it working better. When we were working on designing our rubber band rocket cup, we tried different size containers, different shape containers, and this was one combination we tried. I took this plastic bottle, and I realized that it wouldn't fit down inside of a cup, so I found this other plastic bottle that was nice and slim and thin, and I thought, well, let's give this a try. So I watch what happens when I push this down. It's a tight fit, and it held. And I realized that if I use my thumbs or my fingers, I can actually push up and get it to release. But it gave me an idea. So this made me wonder if I could design something that would allow me to push down on this cup and it would hold the cup and allow me to take my hands off until I was ready to release it myself. And then we came up with this. This is our rubber band rocket cup launch pad. Now we're going to zoom in so you can take a closer look at what we did to design this and build it. So we've zoomed in so you can see how we built this. We're using clothespins to hold the cup as we push it down. And you'll notice clothespins are perfect because there's a little groove that's going to catch the lip of my cup. It's also going to hold it until I can squeeze the ends of the clothespins and release the cup. My bottle's nice and sturdy plastic. It's not going to tip over, and it gives me enough clearance as far as how high it is. I'm thinking this is going to work perfectly. So now watch as I clip my rubber band rocket cup onto my clothespins. I need to open them up, squeeze it closed, and it's holding, ready to launch. So we're ready to launch. To launch this, we want to squeeze the clothespins at the bottom at the same time to get a nice clean launch, and it looks like this. Hold my bottle, 3, 2, 1. I have a nice clean launch. Now when we built our launch pad, we noticed something else. Because it's hands-free and the launch pad's holding it, I can now change the angle at which I'm launching my rubber band rocket cup, and I can do a whole lot of different things with that. Being able to change the angle of our launch pad allows us to change this into a challenge or a game to see if we can launch our cup at a target or into a basket. Maybe we could play basketball, or maybe we could score a touchdown with a football. But how do we maintain that angle? Well, check this out. So let's launch one and see what it looks like. Let's angle it, and let's launch it. Whoa. I overshot my target by quite a big distance, so we're gonna have to tweak something. So we wanted something that would allow us to change the angle of our launch pad, and we realized that this binder, well, it acts as a lever and allows us to change the angle of our launch pad. But how do we keep that binder open? So we thought about using a simple tissue box. Watch what happens to the angle of the binder as I push the tissue box or slide the tissue box in. It changes the angle of my launch pad. I think this is going to work. We just have to design something that's going to allow us to attach our launch pad to our angled binder. So we decided to use just two pieces of tape to make little tabs that allow us to tape our launch pad to our binder. So here's our angled launch pad ready to go. Now the one thing that we noticed started to happen was that as I pushed down on the top part of my launch pad, the tissue box wanted to slide out. So to fix that, we put a little piece of tape to hold the tissue box in place that we could undo, slide it in, change the position, and then tape it back down. Now let's see if we can make our basket. So I realized that if I push my rubber band rocket cup all the way down, I'm giving it a lot of energy. So I don't want it to go as far, so I'm not gonna push it down as far. Give it a little less energy, see if I can get it in my basket. I was a little off there. A little too much energy was used that time. Let's do a little less. Closer. You can see we could turn this into a game. We could move our target back further. We could move it across the classroom and actually try launching our rubber band rocket cups to see if we can get them further. Maybe we could add a second rubber band to increase our distance because it adds more energy. Now these are just a few ideas that we came up with to make our rubber band rocket cups better. That's what scientists do. That's what you can do. If you want some more design challenge ideas or want to learn more about forces in motion, check out our YouTube channel. Science is so cool, especially when we get to launch something into the air. Thanks for watching.